In this video, we're going to talk about a new component to the solar investment tax credit, and that's the transferability, or the ability to sell the tax credit. Before we get into it, just a reminder that we're not tax advisors. You should always seek professional help when making an investment that has tax implications. So, with that being said, Dale, let's talk about the transferability. First of all, who does it apply to?
Basically, this would apply to any person who would purchase, and we're going to focus on solar here, even though this tax credit, this Section 48 tax credit can apply to, it applies to about a dozen different tax credits, but anybody who were to purchase a solar system and could not use the tax credit would be able to sell the tax credit.
Right.
Now, that does not include nonprofits and those that are considered the applicable entities who qualify for direct pay.
So, and this is for commercial, not residential.
Correct. Yeah, this is Section 48. Section 25 is residential in the IRS code. So Section 25, 30%, there are no adders, you can't sell it, it is what it is. Commercial, completely different. Adders for economic communities, or energy communities, and for low-income communities and domestic content, those only apply to Section 48.
This seems like a nightmare to track this. How is the IRS going to actually keep track of all of this? Who owns the system? Who's taking the tax credit? How's that going to work?
They're going to hire a lot of auditors.
Yeah.
No, but seriously, the initial guidance that we got on June 14th says that you're going to have to register the system
right, with
the IRS. So before you start any transactions, selling them, buying them, that system's going to have to be registered by the owner with the IRS, and you will receive a registration number. And that registration number will follow everything. You know, every tax filing that the owner of the tax credit or the buyer of the tax credit, the seller of the buyer, whatever they use, that registration number will follow.
So if I own a system and I want to sell the tax credit, I register it with the IRS.
Yes.
I get a registration number. I'm the transferor. Mm-hmm. You're the transferee. Do you need to do anything?
I only need to file that when I file my tax return, so I don't need to register as a transferee.
Okay.
I don't need to do that, as I understand it. You would simply be filing it, and the transferor would need to give, there would need to be a transaction letter that defines certain, I think there's 8 criteria that have been defined, tax ID numbers, the system, the dollar of the tax credit, the value of the system, the location, and that kind of thing. So that will have to be, that document will have to change hands and get filed with the tax return.
Now, what if I own more, if I have a portfolio of systems that I own? Do I only need to register once?
No, you're registering the system.
Okay.
So if you have 20 systems, you're going to register 20 systems. They're going to track the tax credit to the system.
So let's talk about whether or not you can sell this to multiple parties, or you can break it up. How does that work?
Yeah, so you, from everything I've read, you can do that.
Okay.
If you have a block, a tax credit for a system, you can sell it to multiple parties. And basically, they just get a slice of the entire pie. So that pie could include a domestic content adder, the base ITC. It could include energy community adder, and so forth. So, but you would basically sell, you're going to get 25% of the tax credit. Somebody else is going to get 75% of the tax credit. And you can sell that to multiple parties. It can only be transferred one time.
Okay.
And it has to be a cash transaction. It is not, and again, we're not tax experts here, but it's not taxable income to the selling party.
Right.
Because they're not taking the tax credit.
Correct.
So there's not a tax transaction there as far as that goes. The transferee cannot be related.
Okay.
So I don't think a father could, or a son could sell it to the father or something like that. So there are some requirements around that. And the depreciation is not part of it. So that benefit has to stay with the owner. They would have to use that. The ITC is the only piece that's getting transferred.
Great. Now let's talk about the recapture of the ITC. We know that historically you've had to own the system for 6 years and make sure that nothing, there were no reasons for that to be recaptured or taken back by the IRS. How is that going to work when you transfer or sell your tax credits?
Actually, if it was triggered, it would be triggered by the transferor who still owns the system.
Okay.
And you're not transferring the ownership, you're just transferring the tax credit. So the person who owns the system, if they trigger a recapture event, the guidance from June 14 says that you have to notify the person who bought the tax credit. But the liability for that recapture rests with the transferee because they're the one who took the credit. So How that would work, the mechanics of that would be interesting to understand more fully, but that's the guidance that we've received.
So there's potential risk on the transferee's part. I could sell you the tax credit and then go ahead and a year later sell the system to somebody else and put you, the transferee, at risk potentially.
I would not be happy with you.
No, I don't blame you.
So, but there is the thinking that there could be insurance that develops around this. And you know, there's going to have to be a brokerage. There's going to have to be some type of a marketplace for this.
Sure.
And so as that develops, it could be that insurance becomes part of that transaction component, and there's a fee for that or something like that, where they say, you know, we're going to insure against the recapture.
Sure. So just to recap, in summary, we really don't know exactly how this is going to play out. We have some details on the framework of it. It only applies to commercial entities, to Section 48. Mm-hmm. It does not apply to residential. That you will, if you are the owner of the system, have to register it with the IRS, and you'll be able to sell it. If there is a recapture event, that risk will probably fall on the transferee. You can only transfer it one time. You can piecemeal it and sell portions of it, but that's a portion of the total tax credit, not the ITC add-ons or anything else that would go along with it. And you can only transfer it one time, and it can't be to a relative or possibly common ownership if you had businesses with similar common ownership. So this is just one of the new components to the investment tax credit, thanks to the IRA bill. We've done videos on several other components, the domestic content, the energy communities, and the low-income communities, and we'll have links to those videos in the description below.